Hello underwater friends, you want to buy a point and shoot camera, but you don't know if it's the right choice for you? Well, in this video, I'm gonna give you plus and minus about point and shoot cameras to use underwater to help you make your decision. Enjoy! The second type of camera you may be interested in is point and shoot. I have two models here. The Canon G16, now it's G7X, that is pretty much the equivalent, or the Olympus TG4, now they have TG6. A good one also can be the Sony RX100. I think they're on the 7th generation now. It's a little bit more expensive, but great. Okay, let's do plus and minus again. So for the plus, the positive thing about the point and shoot is also that it's compact. You can easily put it in your pocket and it doesn't take so much space. Some of them are waterproof, like the action cameras. This one, the TG4, is waterproof, I think, until 15 meters without housing, and then you can put a housing. For the housings, it's quite easy to find what you want. Most of the brands will have housings for their camera. Nowadays it's becoming very common, so their big names have housings that will cost not so much money, around $250. Of course, you can also take a big and bulky housing, like main brands like Nauticam, CNC, Isota and others, but the price is going to be very different. Some of the point and shoot will have manual settings, like the Canon ones or the Sony. You can adjust everything, aperture, speed, ISO, everything. The autofocus is quite average, but even if it's a little bit slow, normally you can get very sharp pictures. One of the great things about the compact cameras or point and shoot is the zoom. You can zoom in and out with your camera, and it gives you a lot of flexibility on the kind of pictures you want to take. You may take wide angle, even though it's not as wide as action cam, but it's quite wide. And if you want, you can also put wet lenses on it. So wide angle can become wider with a wet lens. And if you decide to do macro or super macro, you can put a diopter in front of it and then go from macro to super macro and get something very small. The price is a little bit more than the action cam, but still quite affordable. On the minus, one of the main disadvantages of the point and shoot is the focus. Autofocus is quite okay, but generally it's very slow. It will take you a couple of seconds to adjust, especially if you're doing macro and super macro, and it will take some time. You can achieve a great result, but it will be a little bit more difficult, especially on moving subjects, passing by fish or things like this. You're gonna need to think ahead even more, get your focus ready, and then fully press on the button when you're ready to take your shot. One of the main disadvantages of some of them is that some of them don't have manual settings. I really think it's important to be able to adjust everything when you want to do pictures, to decide if your background needs to be blurry, to decide how fast you want your shutter to be if it's a moving subject, and to make sure that everything is adjusted according to what you like. Resolution can be also an option. Some of those cameras don't have 4K. And for pictures, most of them will have 12 megapixel picture. It's kind of okay, but you may not have the freedom of being able to crop like you would have with a DSLR or mirrorless. In conclusion, I think point and shoot is probably the best way to start. You have flexibility, you can put accessories, wet diopters, wet lens. You have a zoom, the price is not so expensive, the focus is quite okay in general. So I think with the price compared to a DSLR or mirrorless, it's a very good way to start. Of course, if you're already an experienced photographer or videographer on land and want to bring your equipment underwater, well, you should take a housing and bring it underwater and you'll probably have great results. I hope you like this video. Thank you. Bye-bye.